तंका आम्ही मिळूया.
आय स्टार्टेड वर्किंग विथ जेनोरा फ्रॉम द डे वन अँड इट्स ऑलमोस्ट नाव 5 years वी आर कम्प्लिटिंग ऑन 26 सप्टेंबर. आय हॅड अ विश टू वर्क इन अ MNC इनिशियली सो बट ॲक्च्युली आय वॉन्टेड टू स्टे इन गोवा ओनली अँड इन गोवा मोस्ट ऑफ द कंपनीज वर स्टार्टअप. इफ आय गॉट थ्रू द MNC अँड देन आय वुड बी वर्किंग एज अ मे बी टेस्टर ऑर अ डॉक्युमेंटेशन इनिशियली मे बी फॉर मे बी 2-3 years अँड देन आय माईट गेट अ चान्स टू बी अ डेव्हलपर बट इट विल बी लाईक अ स्टेग्नंट ओनली लाईक टू बी इन अ ओनली अ वन प्रोजेक्ट ऑर अ स्पेसिफिक फील्ड. ॲक्च्युली आय वॉन्टेड टू लर्न मच मोर लँग्वेजेस लाईक मोस्ट ऑफ द लँग्वेजेस ऑफ द वेब ब्राउझर. इट्स अ बेस्ट थिंग टू वर्क विथ अ स्टार्टअप एज वी आर एबल टू वर्क ऑन द डिफरंट लँग्वेजेस. ॲक्च्युली तुमची जनरलची गोवा टीम असा ती बेस्ट असं आणि ॲक्च्युली सगळे एक एज अ ग्रुप जाऊन वर्क करता सो देर इज नो लाईक डिफरन्सिएशन अँड वी आर लाईक अ फॅमिली हियर. वी आर वर्किंग टुवर्ड्स अ वन विजन अँड आमचं ॲक्च्युली एम असा की वी नीड टू गिव ॲक्च्युली अ बेस्ट प्रोडक्ट टू द क्लायंट. आम्ही आठवड्यभर खूप हार्डवर्क करतात आणि ॲक्च्युली सॅटर्डे अँड संडे आम्ही सुशेगात जगतात खूप मजा करतात त्याक लागून आमकां सुशेगात गोयकार म्हणून ओळखतात.
आय हॅव बीन वर्किंग हियर एज अ प्रोजेक्ट मॅनेजर अँड आय हॅव बीन हँडलिंग द ऑल द वर्क एज वेल एज आय एम वर्किंग हियर एज अ डेव्हलपर इन वेब डेव्हलपमेंट. Like every other Goan, I always had a fascination of going out, of working outside, going abroad. But at some point of time, I realized that going out doesn't give you much more that much of happiness compared to when you be with in Goa with your family. It's not the happiness which I get. It's also the happiness for my parents. Because when you are out, even the parents are worried about you. When you be with them, they feel much more safer, or I would say they would feel much more in a comfort zone, in much better comfort zone compared to when you are outside. Now when people go out, they most of the time think of settling there outside, which your parents most of their parents don't want. They want the child to be with them, be with them most of the time, so that they can spend time with them, their parents as well as other family members. You can spend most of the time with them.
Hi, I'm Sankita, and I'm working as a project manager in Genera Infotech. Actually, this is my second job, and I'm working with Genera from last 1.5 years. It has been a great experience to work with Genora because we get exposure not only with Goan clients but also outside Goa as well as outside country. Genora actually gave me opportunity to work with international clients. It's like fun to work with international client, and that's why we enjoy our work and we are love our work, and that's the reason we deliver the quality product to client. The best thing working in Goa is that first of all, you can stay with your family, you get good food, and you are with your friends and family, and you can enjoy your time. The best thing working with Genora is that Genora is basically a startup, and startup companies always give you exposure and give you opportunities to work with explore more technology and work with good clients. And if I was been working with multinational company, in that case I would have been a junior developer there. But here I'm working as a project manager, and I'm quite happy here. So coming to my team, Genora team, I have best team, I'll say that, because they are the best people who will always encourage you. It's not like I'm leading team and I'm their leader. It's not nothing like that. Basically we are working as a team, and they are like we are like four wheels of one vehicle.
I am working with Genora since October 2014, and it has really been awesome working over here. And also, speaking about working in Goa, actually I don't find any point going outside and working with companies outside Goa, because Goa also provides you with equal opportunities with other company does. Working with Genora has given me enough opportunities to work with foreign clients, interact with them directly, communicate with them, which has boosted my confidence and developed me professionally. If I was working with MNCs, then I would have never got this opportunity to work directly with clients, interact with the clients, which I got over here, and it has helped me a lot. I had two sisters, both are married, and now my mom is alone at home, so I find time to spend with her since I'm in Goa. So that is one advantage that I find working in Goa. They say that Goa is a tourism spot, but I feel that Goa can also come up with IT technologies, and they are also planning to set up IT hub in Goa.
Many of the Goan youth, they are in Goa itself. And why is this happening? This is because of the upcoming rise in the technology in Goa. Okay, there are many startups here, and people know about it. If people thought like it is not good enough to stay in Goa, then they wouldn't have been here for so long. It has never deprived me of any other opportunities. It has been the same, the way it should be, even if you are outside. In fact, we are in better position over here because we are having a work-life balance. That is what is needed in life. There is a lot of scope of IT in Goa, and it will progress. It will take time. Rome was not built in a day, right? So it will take time. And as we go forward, I believe Goa will also be one of the major centers of IT in India in the coming years. Personally, for me and for my parents, okay, the best thing, in fact, this is the best thing that working in Goa has done for me. That is, my parents always get happy whenever I reach home. They feel that their twinkle of the eye has reached home, and seeing the happiness on their face also makes me happy. And that is more important.
Which was launched in Panama, where users can basically submit an ad and also post a requirement. Once a user submits an ad, that ad will be visible to the users, and then other users can buy a product based on the particular ad. Just to give you a quick demo, here is the ad where you can see the latest ad which are posted by the users. There are categories provided in which you can buy a product based on the categories. For example, if you go to vehicles categories, there you will find sub categories on which you can narrow down your search for ads. A user can post a particular ad over here clicking on the submit an ad button. Here you can add up to 5 images as well as 1 video, give the product name, description, select a particular category and a subcategory based on that, then select the price name and give your contact details. Once the ad is published, it will be approved by the admin in the backend side. Now, whenever a user is posting a requirement, if his ad is matching the ad which is submitted by the users, then a quick email will go to the users suggesting that your ad requiring the matching the requirement is available, and the user can buy the ad product. Whenever user posts a requirement, and if any ad is found matching his requirement, then a quick email will go to the user suggesting that his product is available, and then he can buy the product from that particular user.
Hi, I'm going to be explaining the app iWrite. So this app is basically for viewing books and editing the PDFs. So what this app will do is you get a list of publishers over here. This is an app which is based on New Zealand, a publication company in New Zealand. So you get a list of publishers at this side. So this is the home screen of the app. So initially you have a publications list over here. So on click of one of these publications, you get a listing of the categories which are included in that publication. So on click of one of the categories, I get a list of books which are available in the category. So what do I do now is I can click on one of these books. So what happens is I can read a sample of the book. So when I do this, I can open up the app I can open up the PDF in a PDF viewer. So what this does is I can swipe easily and read the content of the book. So the main part of the app is that it has a PDF editor. So on click of this, and I can highlight, if at all I need any line of the PDF to be highlighted, I can just highlight the lines. And then the best part of the app is that I can save this I can use it on a different device with the same annotations. So wherever I'll be reading, if I do a change in this, I'll be able to read on any other devices. So yeah, this is the app all about.
Hi, the app I'm going to explain is used by an Australian company, which is a logistic company. As we know, logistic company, there are trucks which move around, and there are inspections, daily inspection of the truck if it meets with accident. This app normally helps us. So whenever a truck is out for a trip, after inspection, we can inspect the element. We know there are several parts of a truck. Suppose it is the front of a trailer. We have lights, we have headlights, this thing. We can save it. We also can save images of the truck. If there is any damage, for the proof, we can save the images. So there are left side, right side, front side. These parts, we can have the kilometer readings after each trip. This is, everything is stored in the, and the best part of the app is if you don't have an internet connection, you could save it offline, and whenever you return back to the station, you can post the entries at once. So there is no need of internet every time. And another thing it can do is if you meet with an accident in between a trip, it can report a damage. That is, you can post photos of the damage as well as the driver photos which you have met with the accident. You can even report the number, and everything is saved in the database. And now you also get notification once the trip is complete and when the trip is going to start. This is what the app is all about.
App I'm going to explain is Bubbit. Bubbit is basically video dubbing app, and it's basically idea of Israel client. It's basically a startup idea. So I'm going to explain you that. So Bubbit, in this app you'll get listing of all the videos, and videos are categorized based on these categories. So I'll select one of the categories. So I'll select cartoon. So in that I'm selecting this Aladdin cartoon, one of the favorite cartoon of all. Here you can play that video, and also you can just view and listen the audios. After that, if you want to dub it, you just click on dub it button, and then you can just say whatever you want to say, and it will dub on this video. So I'll just show you how it works. Hello, hello, hello. So it will dub over here. So you can just view preview of that too. See. Then you can save, and after that you can share that video on FB and WhatsApp.
Today what I am going to show you is the demo of the college ERP, that is the college management system. Now we have developed this college management system for the Rainbow College. Now what you can see is the website, that is from this website you can register online, that is the online admission form. You can fill it up and you can get registered. Now once you have online registration process completed, next is the online it is up to the faculty staff to admit you, that is that your admission will be confirmed once all the procedures are complete. The next what we have is the class generation of the class through this software as well. The classes are generated as well as the roll numbers are assigned to the students. Next what we have is the attendance management system. Now through this attendance management system, the student's attendance can be entered by the teachers on the day-to-day basis, as well as they can manage it at the end of the month. Now at the end of the month, we have a attendance report generated for all the entire class. Now if a particular student attendance is found to be lesser than a certain level, then the SMS, auto-generated SMS, or as per the teacher's requirement, it will be informed to the parents regarding the same. Now next module what we have is the library management system. Now in the library management system, we have books issue, renew, as well as the return module, wherein the students will be able to issue the books using the RFID cards. The next we have the library module. In library module, the students can issue, we can issue the books to the student, return as well as renew them. Now the library module is entirely based on the RFID card, wherein the students can get the card to the system and they can scan it and get the book issued.
what is the Goa IT Innovation Center about? Well, JITIC was Goa's first IT incubator. It started out in 2011. It started when the Department of Industries, Trade and Commerce and the Goa Chambers of Commerce and Industry came together, signed up an MOU and said that we need to have a mandate that will help IT startups across Goa. So JITIC's focus is primarily to help IT businesses take shape. How do you get into JITIC? What has it done? It's come a long way since that time. We've incubated about 18 different companies, most of which have created about close to 100 plus jobs for Goans and being in Goa. JITIC has a wide reach. We do work that goes beyond just being purely a facility-based incubator. So one of the best things that we've done so far is outreach to the entire IT community. We host meetups called Tech Fridays, which are an unconference-styled meetup. And a lot of the work that we do is to help companies, help IT companies that are here in Goa, IT startups more specifically that are here in Goa, who would need support by way of mentoring, support by way of networks, support by way of finance. We help facilitate all of these to a startup. So if you have an idea that you want to transform into the company, come on over and see us. We'll help you out.
Okay.
So some of our success stories, of course, is Genora Infotech. They're into a host of IT services. Another one that comes to mind is Kaveh. Kaveh, if you know, was also featured on CNBC very recently. A third company you all might have already seen in some of the previous episodes of Tech Balkan is PresentSoft, which focuses on innovations with free and open source software. So JITIC has helped a lot of companies like this to sprout, to grow. Some of these companies, for example, Gladi Animation had started here. It's now Prudent Bay. It's changed. It's evolved. And it's a good thing that companies do that, because at the end of the day, if a company has not learned to adapt to what its strengths are and what the market requires, a company will just as easily fade away. So we would like to avoid that and really see companies grow as we work with them at JITIC. If you want to incubate with JITIC, how tough is that? I think one of the biggest questions that comes to most people's mind is, if I want to start a business, what do I do? The answer is quite simple, right? Look us up on a website, give us a call at our phone numbers, or drop me a line. All you need to do to get into JITIC is to submit an application form. It gets screened through our screening committee. Once your screening is done, we call you in for an interview, and as soon as you're approved, that's it, you can start immediately. The entire process could take a day, or it could take a couple of hours. It all depends on how soon you can mobilize. We would like to work with certain companies that are beginning or at the point at which they would like to begin. We encourage companies that have an idea, or people that have ideas would like to get started. We can help them as well, though we would advise incubation at a point when you are more ready with your idea, you've done your market research, and you would like to actually start a business. So what are some of the services that JITIC can offer you? Well, you've obviously seen the facility. We offer you your internet connectivity, your an office space for you to be in, your electricity, your telephone, access to our networks, of course, access to other people that are here at JITIC. You get to interact and mingle with other startups that are here. We also have a mentoring committee which comprises of prominent people from the industry inside Goa itself. So that obviously will be able to help you get guidance as you start out being a business person. Yep. So also we are part of the MSME Incubator program. We are also with Microsoft's BizSpark program. We're an incubator that is on the radar of the DIPP. When the Stand Up India, Startup India scheme starts actually rolling out, we will be there to provide you with whatever schemes and benefits that are there on offer. So that's what, in a nutshell, JITIC is about. Now, to talk to you about some of our some of the programs that JITIC has, is we're very keen to build the IT community, and through that, the IT industry that's also happening in Goa. So one of the things that we do is have a Tech Friday, what we call a Tech Friday. And if you think that it's a conference, a talk, or a seminar, you're completely wrong. A Tech Friday is a complete unconference, a meeting space, a networking space of people from who have their own startups from the IT community here in Goa, where we get together, interact. We allow one person to speak for 15 minutes on an idea, but the remaining time is just to build bonds and network with other individuals. It's been a roaring success because it happens on a Friday night, after office hours, so everybody has a great time. The other outreach that we do is to let the community of students and academics know that we exist and what sort of IT companies are here in Goa. So JITIC had started about a year and a half ago hosting the IT Roadshow. Now the IT Roadshow is where we take about 4 to 5 entrepreneurs, startups from Goa, take them to colleges and talk about what it is that they do. So colleges are now aware and students are now aware of what opportunities exist here in Goa, what sort of companies are here in Goa, what they're expected to learn, and you know, potential for recruitment, potential for internships, potential even for project work that they would like to take on. And they can directly have an interface with the companies that, that come to them. So, in a nutshell, that's what we do here at JITIC. Always glad to have you. The reason incubators exist is for you to translate that one burning idea that you have into a reality. And that's precisely what we will help you do here at JITIC, through not only the networks that we have, the support that we provide, but working with you every single step of the way to see your idea get to fruition. You can come up with an idea that's crazy, and that's exactly what we will help you work and translate into something that you can actually be proud of at the end of the day. So come on over, talk to us. We're here to help you, to support you, to make your dream.
जिकप्याक आयच्या एपिसोडान दाखयल्ले कंपनी कडल्यान 1,000 रुपयांचो फ्लिपकार्टाचो ऑनलायन शॉपिंग वाउचर गावतलो. ह्या सुमानाचो प्रश्न भायले देसान आशिल्ल्या गोंयकारांच्या आनी बाकीच्या लोकांच्या मागण्यांचेर आदारून VSNL आनी आपलो इंटरनेट नोड गोंयांत खंयच्या दिसा सुरू केलो. तुमच्यो एंट्री तुमी बिरेस्तार मेरेन ह्या नंबराचेर ह्या फॉर्मेटान SMS करच्यो. एका मोबायल नंबरा वयल्यान आनी एका मनशान एकूच एंट्री धाडची.